His job is a full-time job. I mean, people have asked him, "What's he, you know, if he's not mowing, what's he going to do in the winter?" There are a lot of things to do right here. He could spend every day of the week inside this building right here. So we have to give him the resources to do that.
Do you anticipate that we're going to increase legal services that much? Would be that much?
I wasn't anticipating. Here's the trouble with a growing town. You're going to use your legal department a whole lot more than Muncie, unless you're dealing with corruption. So we utilize them a little more. Now, we pay our lobbyists $40,000 right off the top. I'll argue that our lobbyists got us finally a bill passed that got us the four liquor licenses that we needed, and our return on investment will be way more than $40,000 in assessed value. Okay? Way more. Not to mention, we've got to watch what is happening at the State House, what other communities may be doing from a legislative perspective that negatively affect us, what laws can be changed that will positively affect us. I'm constantly meeting with the lobbying staff on what we can do to work with NDOT. That $1.2 million had everything to do with our lobbying efforts. So $40,000 of this $275 automatically comes out to pay for the lobbying effort. That doesn't leave a whole lot of money for legal. So it's worth it. So I think the 275 on the legal line is probably just about right.
I think it's good enough.
There will be some increases thanks to the special census. We don't have those in here. Do you want to know when that's going to happen?
I was just asking a question. I was wondering how great it is when you hear back from Chicago.
We heard back from Chicago.
Wonderful.
They're finishing up Westfield. They let us know, trust me, how busy they are and how many staff members they don't have. So there are communities that were in front of us, and they have to finish it before they come to us.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see a special census being done in 2016. See it being done sometime in early spring of 2017. So we handle the federal government now.
That makes me feel a little fuzzy.
One
question.
What's that special census done? Does it have an immediate impact on Lynn?
Lynn is not, so Lynn, remember, Lynn is distributed based on your levy. In your assessed value. The assessed value being the levy.
The AV, okay.
Your levy, right? So
yeah.
It's population doesn't have much to do with.
Because remember, we're talking about income, so they're using part of revenue information on income tax collection within Boone County. So actually, COVID's keeping up. Lint would be keeping up with what our population is producing from that standpoint. And it's our levies that drive in our share of those certified shares.
Yeah, so the levy, the higher our levy, the more COVID distribution we get. Which means we're taking COVID distribution away from someone else. Just be honest.
So it'd be better to have.
Yeah, if it's certified in 2017.
If there's really positive to it, that's it.
Well, there's a positive to it as soon as it gets done. It's just the sooner that we get done, the better it would be for the community. Because the problem is that we continue to try to create budgets and provide services to a community of 6,000, coming close to 7,000, based on information of 2,400 folks.
April 17th, be interested in seeing what happens to be there.
See if they have an expedited fee.
No, that's fine.
They're already operating at breakneck speed from other telling DACs apparently,
so I'm not sure what expedited means. That's all I have. I think I've tried to be very cognizant of what the public safety teams need to do with their budget. I understand what Chief Anderson and I and town admin share that town general budget. The fire has their own rate, but the fire is also taking co-ed. I get that. So what I try to do with the town admin budget every year is do as much as we possibly can with as little impact on those two organizations. And I think that what's happening on the county level will certainly help take some pressure away from the town admin budget, and we'll be able to do a little bit more. I don't think we're overstaffed by any means for a town of our size and birth rate. I don't think we overpay on the personnel side. I'm not unimpressed with most of our numbers at this point. And now we're operating as a town in the financial situation we're in. If we did everything that we're supposed to do, it costs a lot of money. If we paved every road and resurfaced everything we're supposed to resurface, the roads are a different story. I think we're in decent shape, but I'll certainly do some tweaking if you'd like me to do some tweaking to the town admin side. Adding that assistant town manager of operations. I probably didn't give enough supply money to Chuck. You know, he's got to buy carts and mops and cleaning supplies and keep his trailer up and get a new truck and his salary. I probably need to give a little more.
What would be your way if we funded all the increase for the public safety area? Some of the lit bags to make them back there. $500,000 to put in for buying public safety agencies. What would be your way? What would you do? We kind of asked that when there was one area that's just going to pass us.
I think I'd do, there's two things I would do. Enhance the marketing effort, which would be the best of websites, and I would make the facility maintenance position a priority. It's not a priority now, but I don't want this to fall apart. We've worked on this way too hard for this to fall apart, and so I want Chuck and his position to thrive here and grow and have, you know, interesting. I want him to be fully funded and able to do the job that he does. There's another thing that's as well, and that is wellness of the employees. Now we're paying for some of that right now because they still have the membership to their gym. What I would like to do is look at a program that rewards employees for going through, say, a 12-week boot camp type program, which Matt Hender has approached me and given me a pretty good proposal. He hasn't finalized it, so I haven't brought it to you or put it in the budget. That what we basically could do is have that 12-week thing, but we also track the employees and when they're visiting his facility. That's done by key fob. Now, we can't necessarily stand there and say that they actually use a treadmill or a rower, but if you visit his facility frequently, you get an additional, say, $500 on your agency. So there's a reward to be well. There's a reward to have a whole healthy, well employee staff. And another is the smoking. So we do exactly what the state does. We're going to swab you from time to time, see if you're going to sign a paper that says I'm not a tobacco user. We will do random checks of that. If you've signed a piece of paper that says you're not a tobacco user and we're giving you an incentive, you know, at the state level, you get reduced your premium out of your check if your health insurance is reduced. I think what we do is we give another $500, say, into an HSA account for being a non-tobacco user. If you're found to be using tobacco when that swap happens, at the state level, you get fired. terminate pretty quickly. If you sign a piece of paper that says that, you were in fact not using tobacco, but you were. So it's those kind of things that I think that I would put into the budget to make our employees whole. And so it's those three items. It's a marketing effort for the town, it's Chuck's position, and it's the employee wellness.
I'm all for the wellness side. Let's find a way to fund those, particularly the tobacco incentive.
Completely agree.
Yes, sir, I have. So those are